All right, y'all, welcome to the RFID Lab. My name is Brandon Huff, I'm a sophomore at Auburn. I'm gonna be taking you through the basics of RFID today. First stop we got right over here is kind of our amalgamation table. There's just every nook and cranny of RFID. We talk about passive and active tags here. We talk about the different ways tags are used. We talk about different applications as well. There are two different types of tags in RFID. There's passive tags, which are paper thin. They come with a variety of aluminum inlays, little thin strips of aluminum that catch the RF waves off the antenna. And then there's active RFID tags, which are a little bit thicker because they house an internal power source. The cool thing about active tags is that they are a real-time location system. So every 5 seconds, this will update and provide a new XY coordinate of where it is. Think kind of like a tracker on a spaceship in a sci-fi movie. Passive tags are a little bit more complicated than that. So they use the power of the antenna to reflect the data that they have in their chips, meaning, no internal power source. Because of that, they're much thinner. They're super cheap to produce, I think maybe 4 or 5 cents a pop. So super inexpensive. The main two weaknesses, water and metal. And think about metal and RFID, like trying to talk to somebody through a wall. You basically can't hear whatever they're saying. It completely reflects the RF waves. There's zero chance of the tag being read. Then we have the water tag. Think of it like trying to talk to somebody underwater almost. It's muffled. There's a slight chance that it'll read, but more often than not, I wouldn't bet on it. There's a ton of applications, everything from Great Wolf Lodge badges to Disney refillable soda cups to cattle. We here at the RFID Lab, we're like the best and the brightest in the nation. We are the largest RFID lab in the nation. We are the only RFID lab in the nation to have two anechoic chambers, both of which are gargantuan. We have thousands of vendors that come to us every single day requesting our services. Hey, I want to RFID enable my product. What can I do to start that process? The ARC program is where we get started, and then we validate that through ALEC. And that is a churn and burn, thousands of submissions a day. I think the record for any one employee was like 6,000. But that just goes to show like the amount of volume that we have here at the university. Here we have our mock retail space, meant to simulate what the inside of a real store looks like. We do a ton of in-house testing in here, everything from automated robots to cycle counting to VR demonstrations. I wanna bring you right here to this thing called the cycle count demo. And what this demonstrates, I've got two aspects. We've got the handheld, we've got the tablet. The tablet displays what we have here, 210. What does that mean? Every single red flag around this room contains tags that are in this file. In total, that's 210 tags. What we will be doing is scanning these tags one by one until we reach that 210 mark, in which the cycle count will stop. The goal is to scan all the tags in the general area, thereby completing the cycle count, fully auditing the inventory. In a real store situation, we use something called the paintbrush method, and it's a certain way of holding the handheld and orienting it to get the best reads possible. So what that looks like is what it sounds like. You're painting a wall, so you wanna go up and down, up and down, up and down, all the way around the room, and this is what ensures your most accurate reads. And doing all of this will get you the most efficient and the quickest times. Tags themselves differ. Sometimes they're embedded in the actual barcode of the product. This is a passive tag. We discussed these earlier. Paper thin, I mean super, super thin. You can vaguely see that inlay in there, and that contains all the data about this product. Meaning that chip, that tag can tell us that this is a Daniel Cremo tan shirt, right? This is a men's large tan shirt. And I can access that information by simply pointing this white gun at it, pressing the trigger, reading the tag, and then associating the number with the database. This is our aviation demo, meant to simulate what it would look like for your luggage to go through an airport. So every single time you pick up your phone and you get a notification that your bag has been checked or your bag has been put onto the plane, that means that it is passed through an RFID portal and it has been scanned. And the way we do that is with specialty tags called bag tags. Bag tags are super long. They're meant to go around the handle of your suitcase, just like that. You get it when you check your bag. And essentially it looks just like this. We take the suitcase, scan it, pops up on the screen, and then the Delta worker is gonna throw it down the chute One of the key aspects of the lab is that we have so many student workers, actually around 110. It's one thing that companies really like to see. Clients like to see student involvement, and we also offer, you know, internships, and those students end up getting jobs with those companies, so it's kind of like a good, healthy relationship both ways. And we have all the teams here, VR team, field team, the buzz team. We even have past employees up at the very, very top, but as you can see, the largest team is our ARC team. They have to train for 3 months to be on that team. Very, very difficult. The stuff they do back there, you know, really helps out the entirety of the industry. This is our ground robot, our automated ground robot. It's a proof of concept that we came up with a couple years ago, just to kind of showcase how RFID can work on its own. The goal here was to envision a retail store where, you know, during the day the inventory is counted using RFID, of course, but during the night shift when everyone goes home, the goal is to flip this thing on and let it roam the aisles. And, you know, it has a read range, or it's about 3 feet tall, 3-4 feet tall, has a read range of about the same, and these two white antennas on the side will scan all the items coming out. Right here we have our automated drone, proof of concept, just like with the ground robot, except now it's in the air. So you turn this thing on and it will automatically scan all the, you know, the items that are 40 feet in the air on the top shelf of a DC. We have tags oriented all over the wall. And this drone automatically, you know, decides its path. It will autocorrect by itself. There's nobody controlling it. Welcome to our ARC team and our chamber team. We have right in front of us the super large anechoic chamber. We did get to pick the colors, orange and blue, the way to go. And inside, you'll see, actually, I'm just gonna go ahead and show you. All of these spikes are what isolate the radio waves and dissipate them so that we can create a basically perfect testing environment for product testing. What tags go how well on what surfaces? Rubber, plastic, denim, pharmaceuticals even. So coming in here, very, very careful, watch your step. All noise is dampened. I'm sure you can, you know, I'm speaking a little louder in here, but there's no echo in here, and that's intentional. Same way that my voice is getting drowned out by all of these cones and spikes. Same thing with RFID waves. We have four antennas, all each positioned at 15 degrees on a 90 degree angle. And we place a bunch of tags and a bunch of different locations on the product. So again, where is the best place to put the tag? Very important, especially on items like syringes or metal capsules. Sauce packets is another one. But yeah, you can't do any of that without an ideal testing environment. What do the numbers mean if the numbers, you know, are randomized? So all this in here just kind of allows us to streamline the process and really get good, clean reads where we need them. All right, guys, that was the AuRFID Lab. Really appreciate you guys stopping by. If you have any questions, any inquiries, just visit our website. Just type in AuRFID Lab in the search bar, it'll show up. We also keep all of our research papers on there in case you really want to dive deep into the details of how we, you know, record our work and publish that. Thanks for the visit. See you next time. War Eagle.